Good morning, students. Myself Samuel Prabhakar, principal of Maithon Public School, live back on your online classes. Children, how are you? I hope you are fit and fine at home. We miss you very much. I also hope that you are also missing your school and your teachers. Well, this period of pandemic will pass by soon, and all things will again come back to normal life. Till then, we have to keep our patience and perseverance. Before starting a lesson, as there is a custom that I always go with thought of the day. So today's thought of the day is, where there is a will, there is a way. Children, you must have heard this quote several times, but today I am explaining the real essence behind this quote. First of all, I would like to explain you the term will. What do you mean by will? Will means inner determination. The inner determination or strong determination which helps you to accomplish your goal, your achieve your goal. This inner will turns out any kind of obstacles in your way and helps you to achieve success. Children, you have heard about so many people while studying history. So many great personalities are there. But one thing that is common in all these personalities is that all of them had a strong will. That's for sure. Because whatever they thought, they have achieved it. And this all has been possible with the help of a strong will. So students, strong will can be developed. It is not an inborn quality. It can be developed. But the one thing that is needed to have a strong will is your confidence. Children, never demoralize yourself. Be strong. Be a strong role model for yourself. And always keep faith that you can do. Because this will always make your will strong, and it will turn away all the obstacles that come down in your path for achieving your goal. So I hope, students, you have understood the real meaning of this quote. So without wasting time, today I will carry on with English literature for Standard 8. So students of Standard 8, please take out your literature books and open chapter 5 on page number 30. Okay children, I hope you are ready with your books. The chapter's name is Everything for the Best. This chapter, actually the real central moral of this chapter is that we should have ultimate faith in God, because one who is pessimist and has ultimate faith in God always believes that whatever happens is for his own good. This faith only makes us believe in God, that whatever God is willing for us is for our good. This kind of belief helps you to believe in God. It also makes you a pessimist person, and this kind of thought helps you to overcome all the obstacles in your life. So children, I hope the moral is clear. So I am starting off reading out this chapter to you, and also I am going to go on with the words, what are the good words, vocabulary, enhance your vocabulary. So please focus on the explanation. So the story goes on this way. In ancient times, there was a rich and powerful king who ruled over a vast kingdom. Vast. Vast means in a large expanse. Okay? In a large area. Okay? The king's name was Vikrant Singh. Vikrant Singh was his close advisor as well as a close friend of the king. Caravans, loads brought daily fell into his capital, which proved that the kingdom was quite prosperous. His kingdom was well administered by his ministers under the guidance of Vikrant Singh, who was a good minister and a loyal servant to the king. The only irritation the king sometimes suffered was to see the ills of famine. Famine means epidemic, some kind of disease, an outbreak of disease that takes life, that is called famine. It can also be a natural calamity, a drought due to scarcity of water. The epidemics and the wars which men seemed unable to avoid. So these were those natural disasters at that time which were not in the king's control. And the only the king used to get irritated when such kind of disasters took place in his kingdom. He could not reconcile this with Vikrant Singh. So whenever this kind of things happened and a major loss was brought to the kingdom, he often consulted Vikrant Singh regarding to these problems. And Vikrant Singh often repeated, believe that everything is for the best. He used to say this phrase several times, that believe that everything happens for the best. Now when challenged, the minister would reply that such burdens ennoble man's nature and teach him wisdom, so bringing mankind slowly towards perfection. He told that these all situations are created by God to test his belief in him. So these things can be overcome by ultimate faith in God. So that's why he used to suggest the king to keep that faith in God and not to get irritated, because these were such circumstances which were not under their control. The man was optimist. Optimist means a firm believer in God. Nastik, jise hum Hindi mein kehte hain. So the man was an optimist to the core and no hardships in life. And obviously, one who is an optimist person has no hardships in his life. Because one who believes in God has no regret over any kind of situation that he is going through. And when we have no regret, we can go through all the hardships. He would think of benefits that could be derived from the adversities. Adversities means ill circumstances. In fact, this particular trait was so prominent in him that others around him very often got tired of his repeated belief. One day, the king and Vikrant Singh went out riding on a hunting expedition. Expedition means a journey which is done on a special purpose, an adventurous journey which you can share. So he went on the hunting expedition to a dense forest. They pursued a deer in the forest and were soon lost deep in the jungle. Pursued means went back or followed. So they followed a deer, and in search of their hunt, they soon got lost in the deep forest. Now, as time passed, they felt thirsty and hungry. They began to look for water. At length, they discovered solitary wood apple. Okay. When the king tried to cut the apple, as luck would have it, the sword slipped from his hand and he cut off his fingers. Now, by chance, it's all fate. Just in the act of cutting the wood apple, the sword slipped from his hand and just landed on his fingers. which resulted in the cut of his finger. The king was badly injured. The king let out a piercing cry of pain. He was aghast when he saw the bleeding finger. Aghast means shocked. So he was shocked when he saw the bleeding finger. The minister who came running asked the king, "What's the matter, your majesty?" The king pointed to his severed finger and the sword that lay on the ground. Picking up the sword, the advisor in his characteristic way, again in his usual way, as he always used to be, was about to say his favorite statement. "So everything is for the best, isn't it?" But before he could say out that, the king himself repeated his words and said that, "You are trying to say this, isn't it?" Asked the king ironically means in an anguished mood, in an irritated mood. The advisor was as calm as ever. With due respect, he answered, "Yes, your majesty, it may be a blessing in disguise. Take it from me, something good is going to come out of this apparent tragic incident." Tragic means dukhad, and incident means ghatna. Okay? Tragic incident, which you can simply tell durghatna. Okay? Aisi ghatna jo achhi na ho. God has willed it in this way, so we should not complain. The king couldn't believe what his advisor has said. He couldn't comprehend how the loss of his finger could be a blessing. Because it is hard when you are facing the circumstances, and when somebody, an optimist person, comes and tells you that this has happened for your own good. So until he has that firm belief in God, it is hard for him to believe that this has happened for his own good. The distraught king was sure his courtier was making fun of him. So this anger and irritation made the king believe that the courtier, the royal courtier, Vikram Singh, was making fun of his situation. Seeing that he had indeed enraged the king, Vikram Singh had no choice but to leave the king alone. In his hunger and pain, the king fell into an uneasy sleep. Obviously, it is not a comfortable, it was hard to sleep because of the pain, but somehow he managed. As he lay at the foot of a tree, he was discovered by the tribesmen of the jungle. Tribesmen, Hindi mein hum kabile kehte, who are people who live in the forest, okay, very close to nature, who in the last day of the great annual festival were seeking a sacrificial victim. Sacrifice means bali, and victim means wo prani jiski bali deni hai. So they were searching for a sacrificial victim day, because it was the end day of the festival and they wanted to end the festival with a sacrifice. मतलब बलि देकर वो इस त्योहार का अंत करना चाहते थे. They saw the king and they were delighted. They just seized the king, bound his hands and feet and carried him away. The warriors were in the colorful costumes, as you can would have seen the tribal people in a lot of movies. You could have seen how rich they are, elaborately dressed here with natural colors. So they carried the king, singing and dancing, and holding their spears upright in reverence to the royal prisoner, they marched to the chief's palace on stilts. The tribal soldiers presented their body to the chief, who judged that the prisoner was indeed of royal blood. He was pleased with his minions. Minions means servants. He was quite pleased with his minions. Prize catch. He decided that the blue blood means royal blood. Rasi Khun is not captain. He decided that the blue blood would be an excellent offering to the supreme deity. Deity means Devi. He was quite like that. The royal blood sacrifice will definitely please the deity and she will shower them with blessings. So he was quite happy. Therefore he sent for the tribal priest, an old man who came in soon afterwards. As was the custom, the tribal priest had to approve of all the offerings to the deity. It was his duty to see that each offering was perfect in all respect, because before going for the sacrifice, he knew that whatever ritual was there, that ritual should be perfect. So the tribal priest went through all the rituals. Seeing that the king was going to be the object of sacrifice on that day, the priest did not inspect the prisoner from head to toe. Instead, he ordered that the process be started without delay. They took the king to the altar. Altar is that place where the sacrifice is given. You must have seen in movies. It is a big wooden thing. They put the neck there. That is called an altar, where the sacrifices are usually done. They took the king to the altar. After some wild dancing, which was a part of the ritual, the final sacrifice, preparations began with the smearing of red and yellow powder over the victim's forehead, feet and hands. However, it was during the anointing of the body, anointing means embalming of the body, that the old priest noticed that something was missing. One of the fingers on the king's left hand was missing. As we all know that the king's finger was cut during that incident. He shook his head and said in a sonorous voice, in sad tone, "I'm sorry, Your Royal Highness. We cannot proceed with the sacrifice. The deity will accept only those who are whole-bodied." The deity will only accept the sacrifice if it is complete. But this sacrifice is incomplete because this person or this sacrifice had lost his one finger, which shows this sacrifice will not be accepted by deity because it is incomplete. The prisoner's body is imperfect and is not fit for offering to the deity. The tribunal fled in horror, for they had nearly presented it imperfect. Now the tribesmen were so much feared of the deity, they thought that the deity must be angered, and they just fled away from that place, running. As the king hobbled away, as fast as his legs could carry him, hobbled means running with fumbling feet, and but what of not having his minister's company at the time of danger was that for the best. "Yes," said Vikram Singh later, "for if he had known of the king's peril, he would have come to the king's aid, means help, and been overcome by the numerous tribesmen that serving as a substitute victim." Obviously, it was good for Vikram Singh also, because if he would have been with Vikram Singh, he would also have been captured by the king. And in place of king, he would have been taken as a substitute sacrifice. So that means this incident proved that this incident not only did good for the king, but it did also good for Vikram Singh. So this story just proves that we should keep this optimistic faith in God, and we should deal that whatever happens in our life is for our own good. Because when we deal our problems in this optimistic way, the problems just get scattered away from our path of success. So children, be optimist and be a firm believer in God. I hope you have understood this chapter. If any problems are there regarding to this chapter, you could consult me on my Telegram account. I am always there for you. Next class, we will discuss the worksheet regarding to this chapter. But till then, I would assure you to go through the lesson nicely so that you could be well prepared for your next worksheet. Children, one more thing I would like to remind you, that our videos, our educational videos, are available on our YouTube channel, as you all know. So please subscribe the channel. Press the bell icon for subscription. Just go through our videos, like our videos, and share our videos. Your support would help us and motivate us to bring best videos for you, which would be useful for you in order to enhance your knowledge. Okay children, meet you again in the next class. Till then, goodbye.